tutorials, reviews, unboxings. Find all this and much more tech at DizzyDogTV.com.
What's up, everyone? Doug here from DizzyDogTV. Got a big box in front of me today. We're going to be doing an unboxing. This is something that I've been working towards for a very long time now. And I decided to pull the trigger and order this because I'm in a situation right now where I can actually afford to. And this, for me, is an investment. It's an investment into the video that I create and the projects that I'm going to be working on, the things that I'm going to be doing, creating in the very near future. So with that said, let's go ahead and open this up. I'd like to thank B&H for the great deal on this and also for the speedy shipments and overnight delivery. Alright, first out of the box we have the Sony NP-F970. This is a 6600 milliamp battery, I believe. Supposed to last 12 hours, supposed to have 12 hours of battery life, so this is going to come in, this is going to be huge for what I'm trying to do. And this is the HVL20DW2. It is a video light. Both of these came with the camera for free. Obviously I paid enough for the camera, so it's nice to see something to come with it for free. But seriously, B&H, big ups, man. Thanks for including these with the price of the camera. The camera was the same price as other retailers and it didn't come with anything, so definitely looking forward to putting these to good use. Next we have my new shotgun mic. It is the Azden SGM-1X. It is a professional microphone, that meaning XLR input. Open this up. Nice little leather carrying case. It's going to come in handy. And here you see the microphone with the included shock mount. That is a very, very nice shock mount. Well done. There's times where I'm going to be able to put this on top of the camera if I need to mount it here. You'll see some other stuff about the camera in just a minute, but here we are on the camera, on the microphone itself. Here you can see the microphone. This is the mic itself. It's about 12 inches long, I guess, give or take. Here's the dB pad. I think it's either 10 or 20 dB. And here's the on-off switch. It is powered by one AAA battery, so no phantom power required. Here's the windsock. Very, very nice. Here's the XLR input. So this is going to come in handy. Now this will come in handy. I'll be able to mount it on top of the camera like this, or even put it into the mount that's included with the camera if I need to mount the video mic, or the video light rather. Or this thing can also be placed on a boom pole depending on what we're doing. And of course, since it's an XLR cable, it's an XLR mic, we can run the cable basically as long as we need to, and I won't be dealing with the audio issues of the 1/8 inch jack that I had with the camera, with the microphone that's actually attached to my Canon T2i that I'm using to record this video with. That microphone, the Audio-Technica AT6550, works beautifully with the T2i. Just whenever I used it on my old Canon HF10 that I sold to be able to finance this one, whenever it was plugged in, I was dealing with ground hum, and that's not good. So again, this is the Azden SGM-1X XLR microphone. It's going to come in real handy. Alright, so here we are. This is, again, the star of the show. This is the Sony HDR-AX2000. It is a prosumer camcorder. Records in AVCHD format. Now, in this unboxing, I'm going to do the unboxing, obviously. I've been studying this for a long time. I've read the PDF. I actually have the PDF on my iPad. I've been studying it quite a bit. So I'm going to give you guys a brief tour around the camera itself, and then I'm going to shoot some other videos, obviously some test videos with this. I still have to finish up some test videos, that I said I was going to do with the T2i. So I'm gonna have a lot of fun with these two cameras recording HD video and stuff. And what I may do is I may, after this unboxing, when I'm done, once everything is settled down a little bit, I may shoot a video on the AX2000 just to really showcase more of the features that I'm going to cover today. So, all right, in the box we have a composite cable, a USB cable, component cable. This component as well as a compositor for video out, and here we have the power adapter. That Sony warranty information, content management utility, registration card offering me 15% off of my next purchase. That's cool. I don't think I'll need anything else. Kind of hope not. Accessories, and of course the product manuals themselves. These product manuals, as I do with every product manual that I get in the stuff that I purchase, I store these away, keep them nice and safe, and I download the electronic version of the PDF wherever I can find it, and I put those on my iPad, so if I'm, and my iPhone as well, wherever I'm at, I always have the manual next to me, so if I need to read up something or if I'm bored, need to take in some reading, well, I have it with me. Alright, so first out of the box is the iCup. Here we have a remote control. Remotes are always cool. Love remotes for video cameras. Sometimes they're a necessity depending on what you're shooting and how you're shooting. We have the battery that came with it. Now, let me show you something. This is the battery that came with it. I believe it is a 2 or 3 hour battery. And this is the battery that B&H sent me for free. Look at the difference. So we'll charge this one up first. Once this is charged up, then we'll go ahead and charge this one up and play with the camera a little bit. Should be fun. That is all that's on here. Telling you, this has definitely the most epic and expensive unboxing that I've ever done, and probably that I ever will do. All right, guys, this is it. This is the star of the show. This is my new baby, my Sony HDR-AX2000. I'm going to take you guys on a brief tour of some of the features of this camera and maybe some of the reasons why I chose it. Here in the front, we have the matte box. You can open and close. I love that. It's awesome. Really, really cool. Here we can remove the matte box if we need to put a filter on or what have you. And of course, it snaps back on just quickly like that. Built-in microphone in the front. We have a hot shoe. Built-in mic I probably won't use, but who knows, if I need to, it's there. So that's cool. The 3.2-inch touchscreen LCD is on the top, as well as controls. This LCD is touchscreen. Touchscreen features are, I believe, for video playback. So once you record some clips, you can go through and select the clips, whatever, and preview play. Here we have, now this is really cool, we have three rings here. These are servo controlled rings that control iris, zoom, and focus. So I can put this thing in manual control and I have absolute complete control over the image quality, from the iris, the opening, how much light you allow into the camera itself, focus, and zoom. And these feel really, really good. I like that. Definitely like the feel. Here we have an ND filter. ND filter is basically like sunglasses for your camera. Take it out in bright sunlight if it's too bright outside. Focus, we have auto and manual. Again, complete control over the image quality, and there's the iris. Here we have three CMOS sensors, three XMOR CMOS sensors. One sensor for red, one sensor for blue, one sensor for green. Professional cameras have been using that for three sensors or three CCDs for many, many years. And the reason why they do that is when you have one sensor dedicated for each color, you get better, much better color reproduction and much better image quality. And this camera goes all the way down to, I think it said 1.5 lux in low light, so it's completely amazing, which also works with the gain. So supposedly this camera, from some of the images and stuff that I've seen, has really, really, really good video in low light situations. I'm definitely looking forward to trying that out. Here we have some pre-programmed buttons, as well as some buttons that are programmable. So once I go through and look at the settings, I'm able to customize these buttons for whatever setting I need. This here is really, really cool. Here we have two completely independent controls for the audio gain. I'll show you guys the connections in just a minute, but I have gain control over the first channel, second channel, as well as the built-in mic. So I can set these to record to built-in mic. I can set one to the built-in mic, one of them for the XLR connector that it has, or I can set both to XLR, completely control the gain. Importantly, it's awesome that it has XLR inputs, and I have complete control over the audio, the gain here, but I can control them independently, and that is freaking huge. Here we have auto and manual settings. On the back here, check this out. This is badass right here. Two memory card slots. This camera records in AVCHD up to 24 megabit per second. And it supports, I believe, up to two. You can add two 32 gig cards in here. I need to go today, pick up a card or two to put in here, so I'm not using my other ones for my digital camera. But check this out. You have A and B. I can put two cards in here and push the button, select whatever card it is that I want to use. Select A, select B, whatever. What's really, really cool about this is if I put two cards in here, and I select A, and I'm recording, it's a long shoot, whatever, and A fills up, it automatically switches recording to the B card. Badass, that's huge. I cannot wait for that. I'm definitely gonna put two cards in there. Here's the battery slot. As you can see, I showed you guys earlier the difference in size between the two batteries. That big battery is gonna fit in here really nicely in 12 hours, man. That's gonna be huge, and it's awesome that I got that battery for free. Thank you again, B&H. Here's the DCN, it's how we charge it. Here we have analog as well as digital video outs. This is composite. We have HDMI out, component out, as well as USB. I'm not sure if this is USB out or it's how this connects to a computer so you can get off the footage if you don't have a memory card reader, but that's what manuals are for, so I'm gonna read up on that. Right here, here's the port for headphone monitoring. The people that know me know that monitoring is essential, and you can monitor with this. It's awesome. Here we have the grip. This is how you hold it. And of course we have your zoom right here. Focus and expand. Here's a focus assist. Power on and record button conveniently right there, so it's easily, and it's just right where they need to be. Very, very well placed. There again, this is the iCup. If you don't want to use the LCD, that it's a way to conserve battery life. That's how a lot of professionals prefer to use these instead of the viewfinders, the LCDs. So here is the holder for shotgun microphone. So if I want to take the shotgun microphone, put it in here, as you can see, it's got its own little deal. It's pretty cool the way it snaps like that. Here's the XLR connectors. Now again, this thing supports two XLR connectors, so I can have one shotgun mic hooked up, I can have a lav lapel hooked up, I can have a remote lav mic hooked up if I'm doing an interview or something. I can run an XLR cable to one of my handheld XLR microphones doing interviews and stuff like that. So again, this is everything that I was looking for in terms of manual video control, manual audio control, XLR inputs, two XLR inputs, that you can completely control them independently of one another. And then, of course, had to be SD card slot. Supports SD, XC, SDHC. I think the largest one you can get now is 32 gigs, so that is why it doesn't support anything larger than that. And, of course, the telephone's ringing now, so love it the way that it switches from A to B. And again, just wanted to take you guys on a brief overview and a tour of the Sony HDR-AX2000, my new high-def video camera. For all of us here, at Dizzy Doug TV. Don't let your tech get you dizzy. Later.